Let's demonstrate the various row insertion options we have available. To start with, we need to come over to the row menu for any of the rows we have in our matrix table. We click to open the menu. We'll have an option down here for insert. And we have three choices available: add calculated row, add static row, and add contribution row. Let's start by adding a contribution row, which will take the value that we had from the row that we had added this new row from, and it will show you its percentage contribution versus the total. Additionally, if I come back to the menu, select insert row again, now let's add a static row. I'm going to give this a title and call it digital goods, and I want to include this in my grand total as well, and also have an option to distribute parent value to children, and I'll show you this feature in a second. Let's select create, and I'm going to come to the grand total cell here and start by providing a grand total value of a cost of 10 million. Hit enter, and you can see immediately what cells have been impacted by this, including the row that we're on, plus all of the subtotals and grand totals above it that have now changed in size based off of this new data input. Additionally, I can come over here to the distribution option, and if I select this, I can either distribute to columns equally, or I could choose to apply a trend. This is very useful if I had on my columns something like month and year or other date period, but in this case, I have different regions. So instead, I'm going to come and select distribute to column by weights of. I'm going to navigate down to operating profit, gross profit, costs of goods sold, and I'm going to use the total for my cost of goods sold to distribute by the weight of the actuals. Select that, and there we go. What it did is it took the weight of all of these values here for the cost of goods sold total at the subtotal level, and then took that same weight and then distributed this 10 million across all of these other regions as well for my digital goods row. And last but not least, let's come back to the menu again, and we can also add a calculated row. Go to insert, add calculated row, give this a title. I'm going to call this miscellaneous cogs, and let's go ahead and add two of the rows together. I'm going to add other direct costs and freight together. And I'm also going to select do not include in the total. And you can see that when I deselected that, it also unselected a new option for including charts as well. So let's select create. And you can see that it added the new row into here, but now it has excluded it from all the subtotals and grand totals. Those values did not change. And notice as well the formula bar, which includes the logic outside of the formula pane over on the right. Additionally, if you were to click on any of the cells here, just like Excel, it will show where this value is coming from, which is the two rows above it for other direct costs and freight. And that also gets highlighted in the formula bar as well. Let's close out of this calculated row pane. And I'm going to come into the central and I'm going to turn on one of the charts to show you that disabled chart option. And you can see that both for that miscellaneous cogs row that we added here, plus this distribution as a percentage of total, these two rows are automatically excluded from the charts to make sure that those charts maintain a fair ratio and look appropriate in terms of their size and scale. There's also one additional and somewhat hidden advanced row insertion option. Let's first assume a scenario where you have a table that has repeating subcategories. In this example, my table is broken out by regions. So APAC, Central, and so on is down this list. And within there, I have things like operating expenses, IT expenses, and other expenses. And those, as you can see here, rinse and repeat down this list for each of my regions. And I would like to be able to group IT and other expenses into a new category. So what I'm going to do is I will select operating profit at this level, come up to advanced, go to insert row, and I'm going to select template row. Now notice, by the way, new row has appeared here under APAC. New row is also appearing here as a template row in Central, East, and all of my other regions. So it has created a template for all of those levels of the hierarchy. I'll give this a title, and I'll add IT and other expenses together. And I will uncheck include in total because this is a new group that's not adding data. I just want to have a new row that groups these two together, but not include it in the subtotals or grand total. So deselect that. It will automatically also exclude that from charts. Select create, and there you go. You see that it's now created a new template row for miscellaneous expenses in all of those categories for region.